Hi everyone, it's Tammy, and I know this looks like a mess on my desk, and it is, but we are going to be working with that. I am going to show you how to make a loaded stand-up envelope, and this is not my idea. I got this off of Live, Love, Scrap, and I will try to remember to post her below. If I forget, please remind me, because I'd love to give her credit and have you guys watch her show, because her show, her video, because she's the one who came up with this. I just followed along, and watch one, do one, teach one is my philosophy. So I've already made one of them. I showed this on a different video, but this is the first one that I made. And this is going to be my second one, and I thought that I would go ahead and show you guys how to do it. So first thing you need, well, you're going to need two pieces of 12 by 12 paper. One of them you need to be cut at 8.5 by 12. And then we're going to score this on the long side, so on the 12 inch side, at 1/2 inch. I'm going to take out my scoreboard, actually. I think that will be better. And I know I just have stuff everywhere, but it's going to work. So I'm hoping that you guys can see this, at least for the most part. So I'm taking this and I'm scoring this at 1/2 inch, 1 inch, and then 1.5 inches. 1/2 inch, 1 inch, and I just always go twice, I don't know, and 1.5 inches, and I don't push hard because this is double-sided and it's kind of thick, but it's not cardstock thick. And then I'm going to also score it at 6 1/4, 6 3/4, so I'm doing every 1/2 inch. And 7 1/4. And this is going to make the base of our envelope. So you need to pick out which side you want to stick out. And I think I want this side out. And then we're also, we also need a piece of 12 by 4 3/4. And on this 12 inch side, we need to score it at 1/2 inch, 8 1/2 inches. And then I made a decorative border on the edge of mine, and I'll show you what I did with that. And then we also have two pieces that are both cut at 2 by 3.5. And we are going to score this on the 2 inch side every 1/2 inch. So at 1.5, at 1, and at 1/2 inch. And you're going to do the same thing to both of them. So now we have all of the cutting and scoring out of the way. And with this, you just want to do the accordion fold, where you fold up, then down, then up, whichever way, it doesn't really matter. But what you're looking for is like a W. Or an M, depending on how you folded it. And I want them to be folded the same way, so I want the dots to be out on both of them, or the dots to be in on both of them. Again, it does not matter. And it's probably best to use double-sided paper if you can. And then what we're going to do, you also need some tear and tape. And I'm going to score these. Or I'm going to fold these on the score lines, I guess. I mean, and then you also want to do the accordion on this. So mountain fold and valley folds, or accordion, however you like to say it. You are just making like a little pocket. Oh, I said I wanted this side on the outside, didn't I? Well, then I'm just going to have to fold it the other way. No biggie. And you can use your bone folder to burnish those edges if you'd like. Then I'm going to do the same thing with this one. My score line. And then I have, oh, I forgot to score it this way. Oops. Sorry. I told you one more thing. On the 12 inch side, you also need to score it at half of an inch. Or on the 8.5 inch side, you need to score it at 1/2 inch. Now, most of this is going to come off. You just want one flap that you can put on the other side. And the best way to do this, at least according to what she said, was to, where these are scored, you cut off all of these. And actually, if you do it at a little bit of an angle, it'll be better for you. And then, so I'm cutting off all three of the half inch score lines on the bottom. And then I'm going to do this one at an angle. And then I'm going to just cut off this whole half inch side. So all we have left is one little flap that sticks down. And that is going to be what sticks to the other side of this. So what you're doing is you're making yourself a little envelope that will be like this. Isn't that cute? So what I'm going to do is put, and this is where we're a little bit different, because she did it a little differently than I like to do, but I did it like she said the first time, but then this time I think I want it to be a little different. I'm going to put, on the right side, I'm going to put my tear and tape along that very edge and along this very edge. And then what I'm going to do is take off my tear and tape. And I'm going to first bring this over to here and just line them up. Actually, line them up at the top, because your bottom you cut on an angle. So line it up at the top and then go down. And then fold in as you are moving the envelope so that you can get this on the inside of the envelope so that you won't see that line. That's the only difference. Because in the one that I did with her, you can see the line. We just stuck that on the outside, which isn't a big deal. But I kind of like it seamless like this, so you can't see where that was pushed in. So this is the first part. If you wanted to do a cute edge on here, you could run it through and do something cute on the edge there. I think I'm going to put lace back here, so I'm okay with it looking like this right now. But then this side, you're going to want to, how did this, okay, fold this down, like whichever side, I want this to come up like this. So whichever side you want to be out, and if you have pattern paper that is directional, be careful. And be careful with this as well if you have pattern paper that is directional. Because see how it's, well, look, I wasn't careful. Mine's upside down. Oh, well, that's okay. But yeah, be careful. I was going to tell you guys that and then I forgot and look what I did. Because I should have scored the half inch on this side and then I would have, it would have been right. I was even real careful when I was picking it out just to make sure. And then I picked out this one specifically because it had a pattern that didn't matter on this side, so it wouldn't be upside down when I'm looking at it this way. Now, I did run it through my Big Shot and with a little die, and all the little pieces didn't come out, so I'm just going to help punch them out to make it a pretty little something something. And really, when you're picking out your paper, you want the prettiest paper, I would say, to be this one, because that one is mostly going to be covered up. So if you have a design on it, go ahead and do that now. And I just used my Big Shot with one of my Sizzix dies and just ran it through. And this is going to fit on this like so. There's actually two. And then this is what's going to give you your burnished edge. So mine is a little bit, or my, not burnished edge, my expanding edge. And keep this sealed and allow you to put some stuff in here. So all sorts of things is this one is good for. So I'm going to put this down at the bottom, but you can see where I cut it that I don't want it to be this long. That's okay. I'm going to take this now and I'm just going to trim it off where I don't want it. And I just went at an angle this way. And then I'm going to put my tear and tape on both sides of this. I'm going to go ahead and take it off. Then I'm going to put it down here. Oops, wrong way, this way. Okay, let me hold it here. I'm just lining it up with the edge and with the score line. And before I put this side down to hook onto this, I'm going to go ahead and do the same to this one so that I know that they're in the same spot. And these can be trash. I'm taking off the paper, but I'm going to line it up again with the bottom and with the side. And then I'm just going to close this down on top of it. And I'll put a piece of tear and tape right here. And this should be all the tear and tape that you need to. Not a lot of like paper or anything needed, really. It's just kind of cool. And then I'm just lining this up to the top. And that's what allows it to stand. Isn't that cool? So this pocket is gonna open pretty big because you have the things on the side that allow it to grow. And then this pocket, because you have, you also allowed some gusseting in there, you have some room in here as well. So this will hold quite a bit, which is kind of cool. And then if you wanted to decorate the inside, you could, or even the back side. I know I've seen some with pockets on the back. I'm not doing that for this one in particular, but maybe another one I will. These are so much fun to make. I've really enjoyed it, and I hope that you guys don't mind me kind of learning with you, even though, like, I made this upside down, but I don't think the recipient will notice or care. But see what I mean about it. You really want the pretty one to be on this one, but that's okay. Now I am going to, there's a few things that I need to, I mean, you've stuffed this envelope with stuff. So I wanted, I've already made some things, and I know that I'm going to put this inside. She loves Woodstock. So I found this at the dollar spot at Target. I had this in my stash. It's just a post-it note. I got her this pen, and here are some, here's a little tag. Here's just some things that say Merry Christmas. Here's a little fluffy thing I made. And I made this, and I made this, and I made this little girl, and I made this kitty cat, and I made this envelope, and I put a little note in here for her. So I don't know exactly how I'm gonna do all of this yet, but I thought that I would figure it out with you guys. Maybe I'll put this on the back. We'll see. That's kind of cute. And then I thought that we would put some lace along the edge here, just because I like that look. I did that with my last one, and I thought it was kind of cool. So I think we'll do it with this one too. And to do that, I just used some of my art glitter glue. Oops. And I just run it along the edge. And then I'm going to lay this down on top and just kind of hold it for a second. This art glitter glue dries really quickly. And then I will trim the edge off, which is why I love the art glitter glue for this kind of a project. These scissors need to be sharpened. They are not cutting very well anymore. And I love them, so. So there's our lace. Oh, I also made a bookmark for her because she loves to read. So I just did double-sided cardstock and then put a little tassel on it. So let's see. Oh, and I have a post-it note holder with some post-its in it. And, I think that might be everything. I also have some filler. I have some red filler to put on the inside, so we'll do that too. So let's get to stuffing and see what we want to do, how we want to do this. She loves cats. And you know I do too. So I thought this was really cute. And that's actually kind of cute together. Or I could do that envelope. In the front. I was thinking of putting her here. And I only glued the back on halfway so that she can slide on like that. And I really like that. Kind of cute, isn't it? Then if I did this on the back, it would look like that. That's kind of cute. I think I'll go with that. So I am going to, you know what, I think I'll use my art glitter glue on this too, because if I put my tape on here, these are raised so much, I don't want to make it all bumpy and lumpy and crazy. So I think I will just use my art glitter glue. And just stick this kind of to this side so that when she's in there, kind of looks like they're together. Here, then that covers up that. I don't like that. I'm gonna go ahead and put this on the back. Something like that. Gonna put this post-it note in here. I made this little tag. I'll stick that in there. I'll put these Merry Christmases in here, and I'm going to actually, you know what, I think I'll put it out here. I don't know if there needs to be two. I might just do one, and then I'll put this on with a little paper clip. I think I'll keep this closed with a little paper clip. Give it a little bit of something in there. Put a little paper clip back here. I think I did that the wrong way. There we go. Let's go ahead and stuff this a little. This is at the dollar spot at Target. Don't need a ton, so we'll see how that works. If I need more, I can get more. I'm just gonna open it up and stick this on down inside. And if some of it sticks out like that, that's perfectly okay. And then I'm going to put my little bookmark in there. And I'm going to put this Snoopy thing, this. Oh, and I was just going to give this to her too. It's just the ribbons. And the little girl. Cute. And I have hugs and kisses. I'm gonna put those on the inside. Can't forget the pen. And I don't want to stick her down. Like, I don't want to put glue on her because I want her to be able to be taken off and used for whatever. And then let's see, I'm going to put a couple gemstones just because it needs some bling bling down here. And I like things in threes, so I just kind of do that. I could use more icicle or more of these things too. This is a different one. This is, these are from, I think, the Dollar Tree. My other ones were from Hobby Lobby. That's these. So these are $5.99 for this big bag, but you can get them on sale for 50% off. So it's like $3 for this big bag. This, I think, was $1 at the Dollar Tree. So I don't know. I don't know how many are in here. But these already have stickies on them. And I might actually use a couple of these too, because why not? Oops, I think that took the hole. It did. There we go. And then I also want to make these little straw things that I saw, but I will have to make those in another video and stick them on because I don't have what I need for that quite yet. But I mean, this is just adorable, I think, just the way it is. And I think that my recipient will like it. And I'm probably going to include a couple more things just to make it a little gift. I might put like a Starbucks card in there or, yeah, maybe that's what I'll do. But I don't know. I just think it's really cute. And then so it does sit up if she wants to have it sit up. It's hard now because it's full of stuff, but it's still really cute. And I feel like I might need something else in here. Maybe I'll put some washi in here or something. I need to find one that I know she'd like. But yeah, I think this is it. I think it's really cute. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Have a wonderful day. Merry Christmas.